future is about our future fleet project, where we had 30 electro cars, SAP, mm-hmm. and there was an existing infrastructure out of a research project. There was a company in Hockenheim, close to Walldorf, which creates the charging stations, so the hardware. There was a company creating the infrastructure, managing the charging as software as a service example, and SAP built a fleet management piece of software.
Connected to people, right?
Yeah. So perfect example. So now what happens? The project ended. SAP was saying, oh, CO2 emission, we want to still reduce it. We want to take and have additional cars. So we are a customer. Now we are a customer of a research project. No, we need to have a company fulfilling our service. So what we then thought is really taking this, the whole construct, saying, okay, why don't we try to create a company out of it? We have a first customer, not too bad, SAP. And by the way, this project already has a second customer, which is McDonald's, which is not the first customer as an affiliate system. So we created a company, or we are up to, it's part of now in the Innowerft, the company called Charge Partner. And what they do is really grab an ecosystem for their own. They create partnerships to all these pieces, and they can create and offer a full-service electromobility offering. They have first charging stations in China now, so they are slowly but surely growing. And they are, you know, what we then do is, in this particular case, is of course we network them, we have a guy doing the coaching. It's probably one of the guys who over time will leave SAP, because, you know, that's interesting. Maybe he's the guy who creates the bridge from SAP to this company, because there's still some piece within SAP, this fleet management part, which is currently just flowing around, and there's nobody takes it because it's too small. Now, what we try to do is now say there's a market, there's an ecosystem, and you SAP just need to create this tiny little piece, and maybe in terms of corporate sustainability or fleet management, so SAP could offer a solution and a complete rest of the ecosystem which cares for the hardware and the rest of the thing. That's the complete solution SAP can offer to their customers. And we can create those linkage to a startup that is both for both companies, it's fair.
No, so this is an important point. There's no cash. It is services, though. And the services that you've covered so far are that we've heard you talk about are access to SAP experts to assess a validation of synergy with SAP, coaching, tax, legal. It sounds like there's some real estate.
Marketing, real estate. We have an office, which is one of the important things. So that people can meet. Typically, when they start thinking about stuff, they do it out of their cellar. They do it, right. You know, they're, and it's a very good place that we are sitting in the partner port. The former SAP partner port building, where a lot of companies, partners of SAP sit in. So that's already a good ecosystem to use for these startups. And it's a representative thing. So when we invite customers, they know, first of all, the partner port, oh, it's something with SAP. So just the name, oh, that's an SAP incubator, it's close to SAP, is of benefit for the startups.
So a little credibility.
Yeah, definitely.
Excellent. What about, I mean, the things that, and this is a problem in the Valley, right? You have all these incubators and angels, you know, with Google and Facebook, and they get the angel funding, but yet when it comes time to get to the next step with Series A, there's a bit of a cliff that they're hitting.
Yeah.
Are you providing access to Series A and follow-on funding?
In Germany, it's not like in the Valley. We already lack the first level. I mean, that's why we really start in the very first phase. So we are already happy if we establish a connection to the angels, if we have the first round. We use the 50K to really come up and end up with something like a first pilot with a prototype, with a good-looking business case, so mm-hmm. that we can really show something and have a team set up, which is, let's say, still loosely coupled, because they are in that early phase. The guy is still sitting in SAP. The people and students still doing maybe their master work parts of that, but they're ready to jump into that. They just need the next level, let's say the 300K, the 500K investment.
Right.
We have, therefore, the first early stage investor is the High Tech Gründerfonds. That's an established fund about 300 euros, 300 million euros within. They support high-tech companies in this early stage.
Okay.
And we are partnering with them. So already they know about the quality of startups we create. It's okay. A state fund, okay. A lot of money in that. I mean, you could just ask our own SAP Ventures organization. And you know that they are investing pretty late.
This is something. 10 million run rate.
Yeah.
$10 million run rate.
So we need to really get to this level and having something that the company is running, that it's just in a phase. When you say, oh, it's there, we have proven the success that, or the value that it creates, there are customers, and then really having a growth strategy and getting the money for that, that's possible in Germany. Just need to have the first phase is the tricky phase, and that's our focus.